Welcome, class. Today we are on to physics dimension analysis. In fundamental quantities, we have mass, we have time, we have length. And under dimension analysis, we are only interested in the first letter of those fundamental quantities. So if I'm talking about mass under dimension analysis, I will take capital M. I'm talking about time, I will take capital T. I'm talking about length, I will take capital L. Now, for you to be very good under this dimension analysis, you need to know the definition of a lot of physical quantities. For example, I may ask, what is velocity, the dimension of velocity? But you have to know the definition of velocity first. So velocity is distance all over what? Velocity is distance all over time. So if velocity is distance all over time, that means that the distance is measured in meters and time is measured in seconds. So, and in law of indices, whenever you have a 1 all over a is equals to what? A minus 1. So automatically, since this is d all over l, that means the dimension is will now be what? Lt minus 1. So that means that the dimension of velocity is Lt minus 1. Good. Same way, we have that acceleration is velocity all over time. And you can already know that you already know the dimension of velocity, which is what? Lt minus 1 all over what? T. So when this comes here, it will change to what? It will now be equal to Lt minus 1 times what? T minus 1. So this will now be what? Lt minus 2. And that is the dimension of what? Acceleration. You need to know these quantities because we're going to be using it a lot under this dimension analysis. What am I saying? Let's move on to, for example, I say, what's the dimension of force? What's the dimension of force? And you already know that force is measured in newtons. But first, have a definition. Like I said, you have to know a lot of definitions under this course. So, and force is just, force is the process of what? Mass and what? Acceleration. And like I said, this is mass. So force is equals to what? Mass times what? Acceleration. And like I said, under dimension analysis, that we take the first capital letter. And here you can see that mass is in capital letter, time is in capital letter, length is in capital letter. So this is mass, so automatically what? Mass is in what? Capital letter. Acceleration is what? Velocity all over what? Time. But we have already derived it here, that the dimension of acceleration is Lt minus 2. That's why you need to know all these things. So here, the dimension of force will now be what? M times, this we already derived it here, that is what? Lt minus 2. Are you seeing it? Therefore, the dimension of force is what? M Lt minus 2. And that is the answer. Are you with me? Good. Now, if paraventual, I ask you, what is the dimension of pressure? Pressure. And pressure, what's the dimension of pressure? And like I said, you already know that pressure is force all over area. That's why you need to know the definition of all this thing, like I'm saying. Pressure is what? Force all over what? Area. And you already know that force is what? Force is MA, and then area is measured in what? Meter square. So pressure is now equals to what? MA all over what? Meter square. But you already know that this is what? Mass times what? Acceleration all over what? Meter square. We already proved the dimension of force, which is MA, to be this. So automatically your answer will now be what? MLT minus 2. All over what? This thing is measured in meters. Area is measured in meters. So it should not be what? L square. If this comes like this, it will change. MLT minus 2 times L minus 2. So this will now come out, and you now have an answer of ML 1 minus 2 T minus 2. So this is equal to what? ML minus 1 T minus 2. So automatically the dimension of pressure is now equals to what? ML minus 1 T minus 2. Are you with me?
Good.
Now, haven't learned the how to drive the acceleration velocity, I usually advise my students for you to know if you can't even cram the dimension of velocity and acceleration, because you see it in a lot of all these things we are doing. Do you understand? So we have drive velocity, acceleration, we have drive force, this is pressure. Now we are going to now continue. Let us go on to a little bit of more quantities. For example, let me say, what is the dimension? Is for Newton's first law, we know that M is the product of what? Their masses divided by what? The square root of their distance. So I can ask you, what is the dimension of this G, the gravitational constant? What's the dimension of the gravitational constant? So the only thing you need to do, you have to make G the solid of the formula first, next G solid of the formula. So if I make G solid of the formula, we have F times what? R squared all over what? M1 and what? M2. Now this is force. And then force is what? MA times R squared. And you should know that R is distance. And distance is measured in what? The distance is measured in length. So, and this is capital MM. So we have capital M, let me write it very well, capital M, which is mass, because there are two. Now, this is MA, and what is MA? MA is force. Good. We have already derived the dimension of force already. And having said that, we said that the dimension of force is what? Is what? ML T minus 2 times, this is radius. And radius is measured in what? Meters. So this is meters, which is length, L squared. So all over, remember, this is M, so we have another M here, M what? Squared. So this will now come, want to make it to be linear. So you have M L times minus 2 times what? L squared times, this one will now come over, you have what? M minus 2. So, using law of indices, this will now be what? M. 1 minus 2 will give you minus L. Then here will be T minus 2 times L squared. And that is the answer. So the gravitational constant gives the dimension of gravitational constant. Good. Now, I may ask you another thing. And I say, what's the dimension of electromotive force? Over the time, when I have students this thing, they usually used to have an issue with it. But I think it's one of the most simplest quantities ever. But before I go to that, I will do the direction of electromotive force in the part 2 of this video. I want to run another thing. If I say, what's the dimension of stress? You should also know that stress is what? Force all over area. So the dimension of stress is the same thing as the dimension of what? Of pressure, which is force all over area. And you should also know another thing, that if I ask you what the dimension of Young modulus, the dimension of Young modulus, we only know that it's what? Stress all over what? Strength. And then we know that is the same thing as force all over area. Why? Because strength is changing length all over original length. So if this is measured in length, which is L divided by L, this will cancel this. So the dimension of Young modulus, the dimension of pressure, the dimension of stress, all are the same. They have the same unit, they have the same dimension analysis. And if you want to go further into vectors, all of them are they have the same SI units and the rest. And that is all for this video, but you can try yourself in other quantities. For example, I may ask you, what is the dimension of surface tension? You can answer it and keep the answer in the comment section. Thank you very much. See